In the 45-degree, 45-degree, 90-degree triangle, the legs are opposite the congruent angles and are also congruent. Rather than using A and B to represent the lengths of the legs, we use A for both lengths, as shown in Figure 5.31. By the Pythagorean theorem, it follows that C squared equals A squared plus A squared. C squared equals 2A squared. C equals the square root of 2A squared. C equals the square root of 2 times the square root of A squared. C equals A square root of 2. Theorem 5.5.1, 45-45-90 theorem. In a triangle whose angles measure 45 degrees, 45 degrees, and 90 degrees, the hypotenuse has a length equal to the product of the square root of 2 and the length of either leg. Find the lengths of the missing sides in each triangle in Figure 5.33. The length of hypotenuse segment AB is 5 square root of 2, the product of the square root of 2 and the length of either of the equal legs. Length AC equals length BC equals 5. Length AB equals 5 square roots of 2. B. Let A denote the length of segment DE and segment EF. The length of the hypotenuse segment DF is A square root of 2. Then, A square root of 2 equals 6. A equals 6 divided by the square root of 2. A equals 6 divided by the square root of 2 times the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. Must rationalize the radical expression. A equals 6 square root of 2 divided by 2. Simplify. A equals 3 square root of 2. Length DE equals length EF, which equals 3 square root of 2, which is approximately equal to 4.24. The second special triangle is the 30-degree, 60-degree, 90-degree triangle. Theorem 5.5.2. 30-60-90 theorem. In a triangle whose angles measure 30 degrees, 60 degrees, and 90 degrees, the hypotenuse has a length equal to twice the length of the shorter leg, and the length of the longer leg is the product of square root of 3 and the length of the shorter leg. Study the picture proof of Theorem 5.5.2. See Figure 5.35a. Picture proof of Theorem 5.5.2. Given triangle ABC with measure of angle A equals 30 degrees, measure of angle B equals 60 degrees, measure of angle C equals 90 degrees, and length BC equals A. Prove length AB equals 2A and that length AC equals A square roots of 3. Proof. We reflect triangle ABC across line segment AC to form an equiangular and therefore equilateral triangle ABD, as shown in figures 5.35b and 5.35c, we have length AB equals 2A. To find B in figure 5.35c, we apply the Pythagorean theorem. C squared equals A squared plus B squared. The quantity 2A squared equals A squared plus B squared. Substitute. 4A squared equals A squared plus B squared. Simplify. Minus A squared minus A squared. Subtract A squared from both sides. 3A squared equals B squared, or B squared equals 3A squared. B equals the square root of 3A squared. Solve for B, then simplify. B equals the square root of 3 times the square root of A squared. B equals A square root of 3. Length AC equals A square root of 3. It would be best to memorize the sketch in Figure 5.36. This will help it become easier to recall which expression is used for each side. Remember that the lengths of the sides follow the same order as the angles opposite them. Thus, opposite the 30-degree angle, the smallest angle, is A, length of the shortest side. Opposite the 60-degree angle, middle angle, is A square roots of 3, length of middle side. Opposite the 90-degree angle, largest angle, is 2A, length of the longest side. Theorem 5.5.3. If the length of the hypotenuse of a right triangle equals the product of the square root of 2 and the length of either leg, Then the angles of the triangle measure 45 degrees, 45 degrees, and 90 degrees. Theorem 5.5.4. If the length of the hypotenuse of a right triangle is twice the length of one leg of the triangle, then the angle of the triangle opposite that leg measures 30 degrees. An equivalent form of this theorem is stated as follows. If one leg of a right triangle has a length equal to one-half the length of the hypotenuse, then the angle of the triangle opposite that leg measures 30 degrees. See Figure 5.42.